Hey guys, welcome to the next tutorial of Ethical Hacking and Penetration Testing via Kali Linux. So in the previous tutorial, I taught you how we could go ahead and create the fake fake update file of Notepad Plus using MSF Venom. So in this tutorial, I'll be teaching you how we can go ahead and we will be using the Windows shell reverse TCP payload to open shell on the target when operation is succeeded. So just go, and just to make sure that you know the OL host which I used previously was our local IP address and L port is where we would be using, and make sure that your port 80 is empty because we would be using that. So after finishing setting up evil grade, you'll also need to configure the man in the middle attack using iter-cap and then redirect the connection to EvilGrade server when someone updating the Notepad Plus application for the first time or any time, it doesn't matter. So the first step is you need to go ahead and configure your iter-period DNS file. So if you are using any previous versions, then the iter-period DNS file would be in the slash user and slash share slash iter-cap and iter-period DNS. This would be the file, but over here it won't be. So I'll just go ahead and show you where exactly it is, because this is the new version. It would be in the user and share iter-cap, but it won't be over here. Reason being that the place has been changed. So the place exactly where it would be etc. Over here we have iter-cap, the place has been changed, and over here we have DNS. So just go ahead and open this file. And over here we need to change a few things. We need to go ahead and add a specific address where we could go ahead and redirect it to. So just go over here at the end. So we will be using iter-cap and we would be going ahead and editing this. So I'll just go ahead and open my using the pico, and I'll just go ahead and type slash etc slash iter-cap iter-period DNS. And over here, as you can see, I have my own host name and these addresses where I could go ahead and edit this. So, and just before we proceed, iter-cap is a suite for man-in-the-middle attacks on local area networks. It features sniffing of live connections, content filtering on the fly, and many other interesting tricks. It supports active and passive dissection of many protocols and includes many features for network and host analysis. You can download iter-cap if you don't have this from itercap.sourceforge.net. So to run iter-cap, open a new terminal, and I'll just go and show you this later on as to how we are going to edit that. And just open the iter-cap. You can open the iter-cap from over here. And just go ahead and click on unified sniffing. After you have, just select the network interface. In my case, it would be ET@0 and select OK. And now we need to go ahead and change few things. Next step we would need to enable the DNS spoofing plugin, and this is used to go ahead and redirect the request from victim to our EvilGrade server. So just click on plugins and then click manage the plugins. Now go ahead and double click the DNS spoof plugin, this one. And this would be selected. After that, the next step is to scan host in our network. So we need to go ahead and click on host and scan for host. So three hosts were added. One would be mine, one would be the router, and one would be our active target. That would be our Windows 7 version. Perfect. So now once we have scanned this host, after listing all the hosts, we need to go ahead and set up the target. We also need to perform the man in the middle attack to intercept all the data on the network. So click on the MITM and select ARP poisoning. And select sniff remote connections only, and don't select the one only poison one way, and select OK. So now after everything is set up, run the iter-cap over here from start and select start sniffing. The next step we have to use the netcat to listen on the port 1234 that I have already defined when setting up the EvilGrade. So netcat is a featured network utility which reads and writes data across network connections using the TCP/IP protocol. It is designed to be a reliable backend tool that can be used directly or easily driven by other programs and scripts. At the same time, it is also a feature-rich network debugging and exploration tool, since it can create almost any kind of connection you would need and has several built-in interesting capabilities. So open up the new terminal and just go ahead and run nc space hyphen this I don't know what it is called exactly space v hyphen p and 1234. Okay, v not found, let me check. You check nc. Okay, verbose should be up and running until unless they have removed that as well. Let me just go and remove that. Okay, it should be Perfect. So it should be L, sorry, not the other button. So it has started listening on 1234, that is our port. So when the user opening Notepad++'s application and the application is asking for the update application, automatically, as I've shown you over here, they will have to answer the yes. And our Netcat terminal, we have something interesting because it's already on the victim shell. So what would happen over here is that as soon as the person goes ahead and clicks, yes, okay, I want to update this application, it will be targeted to us over here, that is the Windows 7. Yeah, my Netcat over here will go ahead and inject this, our notepad.exe file over there. That is our payload file. And then it will be redirected towards the SourceForge. So if in case there are any other, let's say, for example, any updates, it will be updated along with our virus in that. So anytime as soon as we go ahead and receive the meter function over here, we need to go ahead and migrate that to a different, that is the Explorer. If not, as soon as the Notepad++ exits, our migrated payload will exit. If it has not been exited, then our payload will run every time the person goes ahead and opens the Notepad++ file. Okay, so that's how it works. You can also go ahead and do this for Windows updates as well. You just need to go ahead and, instead of using the SourceForge.net website, you can go ahead and use the Microsoft.net, and it will be much easier for you to go ahead and understand that. So that's it for this tutorial, guys, and in the next tutorial I'll be going ahead and teaching you about the denial of service attacks, and finally we will see how we can go ahead and DDoS a computer exactly. And if you're not knowing exactly how it works, I'll just go ahead and show you a simple example before I end this tutorial. I'll just open a simple script so that, okay, I don't want to hear about that, so I'll just show you a simple example as to how we can go ahead and do that, and after that I will be closing this tutorial. So I can just go ahead and type over here the one which I created. Okay, so just go ahead and type colon A, or we're gonna type start, and over here colon go to A, I believe. And I'll just go ahead and save this as a batch file. Test period BAT. And I'll save this and I'll go ahead and execute that, and let's see what happens. Okay, the A was executed, and I believe the go to was not executed. Let me check. Okay, it should be go to A, not the colon go to A, and I'll just go ahead and run. Perfect. As you can see that I'm just simply going ahead and DDoSing this network. So no matter what I do, I just cannot just go ahead and close all of these things. Even if I press Alt F4, nothing will happen. Nothing happens over here and the system is freezed. So this was just an extra option over here for you as to how we can go ahead and destroy someone's computer, and just don't go ahead and do it on your own PC, or you'll be going ahead and destroying loads of data. And I will need to go ahead and forcefully close this right now so that it does not hang my computer. And if you're having a big, like 8 GB or 16 GB RAM, then probably it will take around 2 to 3 minutes for you to go ahead and hang your PC and later shut it down. But if you are just like around 1 or 2 GB system, then it will go ahead and quickly stop your system first, then destroy all the files, and then go ahead and shut down your computer. So that's it for this tutorial, guys. In the next tutorial, as I told you, I will be continuing with the distributed denial of service attacks, and finally we'll be seeing how we can go ahead and hack into Android system and what actually Android is, since it is based on Linux, and how we can go ahead and use that up to our advantage using Kali Linux. So up till then, stay ahead with Kali Linux and have a nice day ahead.